So root knot nematode is number one plant parasitic nematode throughout the world, especially in tropical and subtropical areas like Florida. There are several species of root knot nematode, but the major three found in tropical and subtropical areas are Meridogyne incognita, Meridogyne javanica, and Meridogyne arenaria. Sandy soil and warm temperature is the most favorable environmental condition for these root knot nematodes, and these obligate endoparasites enter into the root system and make a giant cell which is gall-like structure in the root and keep on feeding in the giant cell throughout its life cycle. So let me show you some tomato plants infected with root knot nematodes. You can see all these plants, these are infected with root knot nematode of different species. We are keeping these plants to make a pure culture of root knot nematode for our research purpose. You can see some plants here. These are wilting and these are yellowing and the growth is stunted. So these all are above ground symptoms of root knot nematode infection. There should be some galls in the root, but for now you can see the roots. But if I really take this out, see around, you can see some galls in the root system here. Lastly, I would like to briefly talk about management approach of this serious pest. Root knot nematode is mainly controlled by two major approaches. The first approach is chemical approach, where we basically use fumigants and nematicides, and the second major approach is host resistance. So the host resistance against root knot nematode in tomato is governed by a single dominant gene that is called MI gene, and the tomato cultivars with MI gene are working pretty well against this serious pest in field condition. So the major goal of my PhD is to integrate these two major approaches, chemical approach and host resistance approach, to get better control over root knot nematode in tomato and achieve better yield.